Welcome to the Aerotropolis Atlanta Alliance Podcast. We are promising you great information like always, and we want you to land here and take off. All things great information about Aerotropolis. I am Shannon James, your president and CEO, and today we have another great treat for you. None other than Brian Green with the great Georgia Power. Welcome to us. Brian, how you doing, my friend?
I'm doing good. Glad to be here. Thanks, Shannon.
No, man. Glad to have you, man. You know, I know that this is a new opportunity for the area for you. And all of our listeners are excited anytime we have Georgia Power in the house because you guys are true power, man. I mean, no pressure, but our former chair, Mr. Pedro Cherry, obviously speaks highly of not only you, but the graces of our partnership. So we're fortunate to have you. Yeah. Seriously, Brian.
Glad to be here. And you made a good point there, Shannon. You know, Georgia Power has been a big champion for Aerotropolis since its inception. And I'm just grateful to have the opportunity to continue a lot of the good work that's already been taking place and hoping to do my part to support you and all the efforts that are underway here.
No doubt, man. It's a team effort. We truly believe in partnership. And you're right. Georgia Power has been here since inception. No question, man. So, hey, man, listen, you step right in like no other. And so what I want to do is help our listeners understand who we have in the room with us today. Brian, tell us about yourself, your background, you know, where you're from, anything you'd like for our listeners to know today.
Yeah, no doubt about it. So I'm coming back home. So I've been working with Southern Company for about 15 years now.
Ooh.
Started my career at Georgia Power as a co-op student back in 2001. So
wow.
I'm a native of Georgia.
Okay.
Grew up in Covington, Georgia. Graduated from Georgia State. So had the great opportunity to start my career right here in Atlanta. And as I kind of grew in my career, had the opportunity to go out and do a couple different things in the Southeast, which gave me a great opportunity to kind of grow my bandwidth and diversify my skills. So I have a marketing degree from Georgia State.
Nice.
Spent the bulk of my career in Georgia Power's corporate communications department, and I held various roles during that time, but always had a real desire to get outside of the corporate office and work on the community level. So had a good opportunity to go down to Mississippi Power and do some community development work. What I really kind of noticed early on, Shannon, is how competitive the Atlanta market can be, especially when you're trying to diversify and do some different things. So I went down and had an opportunity to do some community development work in Mississippi Power service territory down on the Gulf Coast of Mississippi.
Nice.
Spent a lot of time in the city of Moss Point.
Did you gain any weight down there?
A little bit. But, you know, the issue there is, Shannon, I have a shellfish allergy. So it counted me out from a lot of the good cuisine down there on the Gulf Coast, but it was a great experience.
I bet it was.
And so I took I left Gulfport and went over to Birmingham, spent about a year and a half there working back in communications, and then this opportunity came up. So I'm really excited to be home and glad to be back in Georgia.
Man, listen, we're glad to have you back. And you know what, it speaks a lot about your background, right? You started out ground level and just literally work your way up. I mean, that is impressive. You know, it always is easier to see the finished product versus when you're going through, man. So listen, we're happy that you're here. Congratulations on all your success. And more importantly, we're glad to have you here in the Aerotropolis. And knowing that you've got an Atlanta background, right? This is personal for you.
It's very personal.
Yeah, this isn't about a job. This is more about a mission, if you will.
That's right.
And so our organization is committed to, you know, growing maybe your mission for the area as well. And so what I'd love to do is maybe think about, you know, your role and responsibilities with Georgia Power now that you've worked your way up from ground level, from Mississippi Power to being in Birmingham, and now you're in Atlanta.
That's right.
So let's maybe help our listeners understand what your now role and responsibilities are.
That's a great question. So right now I'm serving as the community development manager for Metro South. So the way we're structured, we have an economic development organization within Georgia Power. So within that team, you have a few departments working together. So we have a project manager team that works with the state, and they're working with those business prospects and really trying to get them to take a look at Georgia as a potential landing spot to locate their businesses. So that's one side of the house. My side of the house, the community development side of the house, we have a number of managers that work across the state with communities, and you can consider us the boots on the ground personnel within Georgia Power. So our main goal is to work with communities throughout the state of Georgia and make sure that those communities are positioned for growth. And we do that in a number of ways. We refer to the Georgia Power Triangle. So Georgia Power has been participating in the economic development space for over 100 years. You may not know this, but our first president way back in the early inception of our company, he understood the importance of attracting industry to Georgia. So we had an office back in the early part of our company's development in New York, and we were trying to attract industry to the state. And that was when we first made our way into economic development. And since then, Georgia Power has been committed to it.
You know, it's interesting you bring that up because for a guy like me, early on, when I think Georgia Power, I think about my bill, right?
That's right.
At the house, man. Like, okay, now last month, Georgia Power. Now this month, Georgia Power. What's going on, Georgia Power? But now it sounds like what our listeners can hear is more to that than just a residential service component or even commercial. It's more about also economic development. And so that's huge, man. I mean, I don't think most people even realize that Georgia Power has state project managers and, you know, a truly devoted economic development team.
Yes.
So that's good information, man.
No doubt about it. And one more thing to add there, Shannon, is the fact that we, you know, one of our leading mantras within the company is to be a citizen wherever we serve. So we do serve our customers with electricity, but we also are working every day in so many different ways to make our communities a better place, better places to live, work, and play. You know, one thing we say, if you've noticed our ad campaign recently, we've said it's our home too.
Right.
And we live right beside, you know, our neighbors that we serve and provide power to. So we want to make sure we're not only just making sure the lights come on when you flip that switch, but we're also embedded within these communities and working with our partners in the communities and make sure we have sustainable communities and we're positioned for growth for the long run.
Oh, man, listen, now you're talking, man. This is the magic because I'm sure our listeners all want to know about exactly that, right? How is Georgia Power now being more of a an added tool or conduit, if you will, for the community when it comes down to growth and opportunity or improving their live, work, play status.
That's right.
And something that you and I talked about that was a learning experience for me, to be quite honest, was I always understood that there was a workforce development component. And through the Aerotropolis Atlanta Alliance, workforce development is a big component of ours. I mean, it's an anchor, if you will. And so knowing that Georgia Power also does workforce development, in particularly for communities, can you maybe elaborate to our listeners about what workforce development could look like or what's already in place for Aerotropolis communities when it comes down to workforce development?
Sure. So we approach it from a number of different ways. I spoke about our community development team under the economic development organization and our statewide project managers. But we also have another arm where we're specifically focused on education. So have energy efficiency education coordinators within schools from all the way from K to 12. So we have a group of employees that their number one job is to go into schools throughout the state of Georgia and educate them on the importance of STEM education. So we feel like it's very important to have a voice in the schools throughout our service territory and not only educate students on who Georgia Power is as a power company, but also open their minds up to the wonderful world of STEM.
That's strong.
We want to talk
man.
A lot about, you know, opportunities in the energy industry.
Yeah, man.
But we also want to let them know how important it is to focus on engineering and science. So we'll have that crop of talented individuals ready to take on these jobs 15, 20 years down the road. So that's one way we approach it. And our coordinators are working every day to do that and bring that message home.
Wow.
In addition to that, in my role, we have an opportunity also to work with the different development authorities throughout the state, especially so for me, focused in Metro South.
Right.
I'll work with development authorities and we can work and partner with technical schools to make sure we're always looking to understand what prospects are looking for when they when they select communities to locate in and making sure that these community colleges are positioned and agile enough to meet the needs of those incoming prospects. So we can come in and partner one-on-one with economic development authority boards and others to make sure these technical schools are positioned for that growth that's coming.
Oh, that's important, man. I mean, listen, you're hitting several keynotes. I mean, we've got a few technical colleges here in our world, Atlanta Tech, which is one I think that we've done a really good job of partnering with them. And I can speak about several, but I think it's important because our communities want to position ourselves so we can receive those corporate investment opportunities or those new companies that are looking to locate. Or if you've got a few developers who want to bring a special project, we want to land them, especially in the backyards that you're playing in. And I'm sure that's music to our vice chairman ears, Ms. Lisa Smith. Lisa, hello, good morning, good afternoon, whenever you get this, because Lisa has been a powerful leader in our organization, and she speaks about education a lot.
That's right.
She speaks about workforce development a ton, and so housing. I mean, I can go on and on about the great Lisa Smith, and I know that we were just talking about Lisa before we even started. There was a great event in Clayton County called Communities on the Rise. It was hosted by our own Commissioner Franklin Warner, and Lisa Smith participated, and her communication was phenomenal. I mean, Lisa articulated the vision and being for Georgia Power, especially for Clayton County. So it was really good to hear that information, and more importantly, hearing it from you, because I didn't realize her bandwidth was so large. Oh, my God.
Busy.
And not just hers, but yours, too, my friend.
So,
but we're glad that the Aerotropolis is a focal point for what you're doing, because we want to continue to push ourselves to be more regionally economically competitive. And in order to do so, we need great partners like Georgia Power, right? And everything that you just mentioned are all the tools or ingredients to position us to be just that. And while we're kind of talking about that, is there anything that you would want our listeners to know, because there may be something on the website that they could maybe familiarize themselves with, or anything that we may have not talked about or communicated that may be good for our listeners that they should know?
Sure. So, you know, I talked a lot about how long Georgia Power has participated in the economic development space, and a lot of our customers and partners don't really realize that. But one thing I would like listeners to know is that we are working just as hard as anyone throughout the state to make sure that we are promoting Georgia to the nation and the world, to make sure when prospects are looking, they understand, hey, we got a great story to tell here in Georgia. Please come take a look. So we're always working behind the scenes in that way. One good way to find out a lot about what's going on is to go online to selectgeorgia.com. On that site, that's the site that we really promote. And we're working with communities across the state to make sure that all the inventory, you know, industrial parks and site selection locations are listed on Select Georgia. So when those prospects are taking a look at Georgia, they can go to that one-stop shop and find all those potential properties to place their businesses within the state of Georgia. So you'll find out a lot of that information on selectgeorgia.com. You can also find out a lot more information about the Community Economic Development Team and our efforts. You'll find our workforce development energy education information on that site as well. So it's just a wealth of information located on that site where it'll give you a different sense of, you know, what other role Georgia Power plays outside of keeping the lights on. And you can also land on georgiapower.com. You know, you'll have to take a couple more clicks to get there, but we also have a link to the economic development site from georgiapower.com as well.
Man, listen, Georgia Power is a juggernaut. And I want to thank you guys, because if our listeners go to our website at www.aeroatl.org, under economic development, our great partners at Georgia Power actually put together a great workforce development map for the Aerotropolis specifically. So if you go to our website, you can go to our economic development tab, and you'll be able to find where workforce development data, opportunities, geographies, it is all mapped out on our website. And our great partners at Georgia Power literally took the time out to do that great work. And I can speak to all the great names that we work with at Georgia Power, from obviously Pedro Cherry or Lisa Smith or Steve Foster. I mean, the names go on and on, and you guys have done.
Got been Tina Terry as well.
Tina Terry, that's right. Can't forget about Tina. Yeah, I mean, you guys have such a great brand, a great energy, if you will, about yourselves. And obviously, you know, you guys are picking the right people because you guys are doing the right job. And we're just fortunate to have you guys in the room, at the table, you know, ingratiating yourselves. And so I'm fortunate to have you on the team. I think we all are. And I'm looking forward to the future, my friend. Ultimately, I think that our listeners can take away is that not only is Georgia Power a power company, right? They're able to supply the demand that's needed for the communities, that's but right. also you guys are the community, right? You're in the community. You're doing the service. There's workforce development. There are educational components. There's leadership that are literally roaming our backyards here every waking moment. And we just cannot be grateful enough for you guys, man. Listen, thank you for joining us. Our listeners, as you can tell, Brian is an ultimate professional. Not only is he a hard worker, but he's committed to the success of our communities and our area. And I can personally tell you that through my relationship with Brian and the conversations that we're having, I think we've gotten a jewel here. And we're fortunate. So, Brian, thank you for joining us. And thank our listeners for joining us here today, listening to all this great information. I hope you learned some new stuff about Georgia Power and, more importantly, their commitment and connection to the Aerotropolis community. So, again, Shannon James, your president and CEO, and we want to help you land here and take off. Thank you.